फंस।
या प्लीज।
यस सर, वी आर लाइव सर।
डियर मेंबर्स एंड व्यूअर्स ऑफ द व्हाइट आर्मी, वेलकम बैक टू नेशनल लेवल ऑनलाइन डर्मेटोलॉजी क्विज प्रेजेंटेड बाय द व्हाइट आर्मी, द एपिग्नोसिस। टुडे at 2 o'clock we had the preliminary round consisting of 30 questions and participated by within the time limit of 2 to 2:20 p.m. we had more than 225 students participating in the preliminary round, and in that the top participants, top 5 participants qualified for the final round, and also we have two more privileged participants with us in the finals. And first of all, I would like to take this privilege to introduce the quiz masters of today's dermatology quiz. Dr. Sachin Shekhar, who is a MD dermatology from a Bangalore Medical College and Research Institute. And also Dr. Hira, who is also MD dermatology from Bangalore Medical College and Research Institute. Both of them were the first Asian dermatopathology quiz winners. Recently held dermatopathology quiz, first Asian dermatopathology quiz winners. So first of all, I would like to congratulate them for this achievement, and also welcome for hosting this today's dermatology online quiz final rounds. Welcome to both of you, Dr. Shekhar, Sachin Shekhar and Dr. Hira.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr.
really
Kishan.
Honored and privileged to have you with us today.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Kishan. And this is our second dermatology quiz doing from the White Army. So I'd like to sincerely thank Dr. Kishan and his members for giving us this opportunity. So it's a great platform for the interns and the third years and fourth years to learn from this platform. So we'll start with the quiz.
Once Sachin, I'll also please introduce the finalists today. Today in first place, in the preliminary round, the first place was backed by Miss Ashmita, who's a third year student from Sage GS Medical College and KM Hospital, Mumbai. Congratulations, well done, Ashmita, and welcome to the finals. Okay. How was the preliminary round questions, Ashmita? I want just a feedback from you. How was the preliminary round?
Sir, the prelims were excellent. Like the questions, those 30 questions, they were very much clinically oriented. And almost for every question, we had to, it required proper thinking and analyzing skills to come to a diagnosis and then choose the correct answer. So I enjoyed the prelims a lot, and I look forward to learn a lot in the coming quiz.
Wonderful, wonderful. I really it was like very big surprise. A third year girl topping this such a dermatology quiz, that too with a 43 out of 46. It's a great score. And Sachin, to be honest, she has been preparing for last 1 week or 10 days or so for this, exclusively for this quiz. That much of hard work she has put in. So I was in the first, when I called her, I asked, is it really true? Are you a third year UG or third year dermatology PG? I asked her. Because 43 out of 46 in such a dermatology quiz is literally, it's very difficult. But then she told, no, sir, I have been exclusively working for this quiz for last 10 days. So the hard work has yielded the good results for her. And she has topped the preliminary round. In second round, second place, we have Mr. Srinath, Srinath Rao from fourth year from Bangalore Medical College and Research Institute. And he stood second in the preliminary round. Welcome to you, Srinath.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
And how was the preliminary round for you?
It was good, sir. It was both clinically oriented and also image based questions were there, sir. It was good, sir. It was also like practicing papers. Nice.
Yeah, you also. And in third place, we have Dr. Vallabh Sheth, who is doing his internship in Bangalore Medical College and Research Institute. He has scored 36 out of 46. Well done, Vallabh, and welcome to you for the finals. He has been the very regularly, he has been participating in all the quizzes of the White Army, and has won the many quizzes also in previously. And welcome to you. How was the prelims for you, Vallabh?
Thank you. Prelims was a little hard on me.
Harder? In a way?
Slightly. I forgot a lot of things.
Because you're intern now, you're busy working there in the hospital. So theory, anyway, even you in BMC has got one of the best dermatology departments in our country. So when you go to the department, literally you will get to see all kind of cases and you will learn a lot there. Okay. So
yes,
keep waiting for that. In the fourth place, we have Himang Gupta from Government Medical College, Faridkot, Punjab. He's in fourth year MBBS. He's a post intern. Am I right? Himang?
Yes, sir. I'm post-intern.
Yeah, post-Himang. Now he has joined as a medical officer in Faridkot. So welcome to you, doctor. Well done. I missed your,
thank you.
Your working hours there. You managed to participate in the quiz and stood in the top among toppers. Well done. Himang Gupta
thank
is
you,
also
sir.
A very active member of the White Army. And welcome to you. How was the prelims for you?
Prelims was good, sir. It was clinically oriented and the questions were very good for me.
Yeah, similar kind of questions you get in all your PG entrance exams nowadays. Okay, similar, very similar yes. kind of questions. So if you're able to crack these questions, it's any of the PG entrance exams will be easy for you. Okay, well done. Yes. And expecting you the same from you also in finals. Okay, in fifth place, we have Nimisha June. From Army Medical yes. College, New Delhi. Hi, Nimisha.
Yes,
welcome to the finals
sir.
Of the dermatology
Thank you
quiz.
So much, sir. Thank you.
Yeah,
Thank
we
you,
are
sir.
Really privileged to have you with us today. And you've done really well in the prelims. Okay. So, how was the prelims for you? Questions?
So, initially, I thought dermatology is going to be extremely difficult. I have a great difficulty in learning all the terms. But the questions were very, very interesting.
Quizmaster proved you wrong. Quizmaster proved you wrong, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Absolutely.
They made the dermatology interesting for
Very
you.
Very interesting, sir. Yes, sir.
So next we'll have a budding dermatologist here now, Nimisha. Okay, upcoming dermatologist. Yeah.
Thank you.
Well done, Nimisha. Okay.
And, thank you so much.
You are in the fifth place, and in as the privileged participants today, we have two of the best participants of today's preliminary round, Dr. Nuren. Who is from SDM Dharavad. Welcome to Dr. Nuren.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you had scored well, but because of some tie in the scores, you had stood sixth. So you are a privileged participant today. If the main five participants, if they don't answer, then the questions will be directly asked to you. You are the privileged to answer, okay?
Yes,
do well. And in another privileged participant for today's, Shreyas. Mr. Shreyas, a fourth-year student from Saptagiri Medical College, Bangalore. Welcome to you, Mr. Shreyas.
Thank you, sir.
You did really well. Okay, we did really well. So, but because of our rules,
yes.
You are a privileged participant today. And it's good for you only. See, yes. Finally, we are all here, like Sachin just told, and Ashmita also told, we are here to just to learn here. We are not here for behind any cash prizes or in big awards here. We are here, all the like-minded students here. So we are here to learn more and more about the dermatology. And that will be definitely done. That purpose will be served. Okay. So anyway, it's going to be a very good learning opportunity and experience for all of us. So yes, expecting a lot to learn from you today. Okay.
Yes.
You will also be learning indirectly. We will also be learning through your answers. Okay. Be confident.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
And many other active members are joined today's session. Kaustubh is there and Akshay and many other part. Rishabh is there and many other participants I can see. And our host for the today is Mr. Kunj. Welcome to you, Mr. Kunj. And also as a scorer and moderator, we have Pallavi, core member of White Army from MMCRI, fourth year medical student. Welcome to Kunj and Pallavi also for today's finals.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, scorer ready? Pallavi, ready?
Yes, sir.
Quizmasters ready? Sachin and Dr.
Yes.
Hira?
Yes. So, Kishan,
Hira?
Before we form missions, we're subjective to our first year PGs. And as you told, the place winner has scored 43. The first year PGs, the highest mark was 35. So, I think it's an extraordinary job for a third year to score 43 in this set of questions. So, let's start with the quiz. So, I'll ask to her take over.
A very good afternoon, everyone, and I'm really sorry for the technical glitch that occurred. And yeah, I'm Dr. Hira, and I'd like to thank Dr. Kishan for this amazing opportunity. We had a really fun time and like making the quiz questions, and we had to think it out. And I'm really glad you guys like the prelims. Okay, so we'll start with today's quiz. So firstly, I would like to welcome all of you to today's quiz, and I would like to specially thank White Army with this dedicated effort in like appreciating and teaching everyone, and especially undergrad, where you don't get a lot of like not all colleges have that opportunity to, you know, get dermatological clinical practice. So this is a very good opportunity for everyone to learn. So like, yeah, as I said, today there's going to be four rounds, three rounds and one rapid fire. Out of that, first round is basics. Round two is clinical dermatology. Round three is drugs and dermatology. And round four is rapid fire questions. Round one, two, three, five questions are there in each round. One question will be directed for each team. Each correct answer carries 10 marks. The fourth round is rapid fire. Each team will get 10 questions and they have to answer that in 1 minute. Each question carries 3 marks. There will be no passing of any questions. So all the to advise you to listen to each question completely, carefully, and give only one answer. So if you shoot out multiple answers, that will not be considered. And rapid fire questions, be quick. Do not, if you do not know the answer, do not waste time. Go to the next question. And once you pass the question and go to the next one, you cannot come back to it even at the end. So yeah, it's your call. And yeah, no use of internet to search any of the answers. And the question passes to the audience in the end if no answers received from any of the team. And as always, Quizmaster's decision is final.
So we'll start with the round one, basics. This question is related to the basics in dermatology, which everyone should know. So there'll be one question which carries two sub-questions, and each sub-question carries 5 marks, and there'll be no passing of questions. If candidate fails to answer, first it will pass on to the privileged members, and next it will go on to the audience who can use the chat box to answer, and multiple answers are not accepted. So coming to the first, let's see, that is Ashmita. Ashmita, are you ready?
Yes, sir. The time limit for each question?
30 seconds.
Okay, sir.
Okay, Ashmita, it's your first question. Identify this reaction and name one disease that shows this reaction. You should identify this reaction and name a disease which associated with this reaction.
So this is a type 3 hypersensitivity reaction and post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, PSGN, is an example of this reaction.
Very good, very good.
Perfect start for the quiz. Perfect start.
So type 3 sensitivity reaction is, but post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, is it type 3?
Yes, sir. PSGN is also type 3.
So, yes, yes. Earlier it was thought as type 2. Now it is type 3 only. So we'll give it to you. So you get 10 points. So Ashmita gets 10 points. So coming to team B. Srinath?
Yes, sir.
So this is a question. A 45-year-old male presented with fluid-filled lesions all over the body, including the oral cavity, direct immunofluorescence was performed. So your question is, identify the pattern and name the condition associated with this pattern.
It's a fishnet pattern which is seen in
You are correct. It is fishnet pattern. Now coming to the second subpart. What is the common condition which we do for DIFO?
Pemphigus foliaceus.
Okay, I'll give it to you. Yes, exactly. It is pemphigus. Pemphigus group of drugs are intraepidermal blisters will be seen. Subepidermal blisters are seen in pemphigoid group. So in any case of pemphigus disorders, you can see fishnet pattern. Depending upon the level of fluid, you can up or lower down. So congratulations, Srinath. You have got 10 points. Now coming to team C, Vallabh. Vallabh, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
So team C, it's your question. Identify the procedure being done and name the stain used. On the left side of screen is a procedure which is being done. and right side of the screen there's an image for which you should tell what stain is being used in that image. It's a common procedure which we do in dermatology.
Not sure, sir.
At least the second one, if you can identify.
Acid fast.
Excellent. What is that?
Acid fast reaction.
Acid fast vessel, you can see. So what is the stain used?
Z Nielsen.
Excellent. It is Z Nielsen stain. So retrospective, can you tell the procedure being done?
Is this for scrofula?
So the question passes to the privileged members. Neurin or stress, anyone can attempt.
Sir, split screen.
Yes, exactly. It's a slit skin smear technique used to diagnose cases of leprosy. Okay. And this is an acid fast bacilli, which you can see, which is identified by Z Nielsen stain. We get 5 points.
Okay.
So the next question is for. Are you ready?
Yes, sir. I'm ready.
So here's your question. So you can see three. One is a picture, one is a special stain, and one is in an electron microscopy. So identify the cell which is common among the three images, and name an immunohistochemical marker for the same.
So this is a Langerhans cell present. Excellent. In the skin, and histochemical marker is CD1A.
Excellent. So how do you tell it is a Langerhans cell?
The tennis racket appearance in electron microscopy, it is diagnosed. I think it is very diagnostic good. Of Langerhans cells.
Very good. And its location in the lower
spinal cord. Yes.
So can anyone tell the other immunohistochemical markers for Langerhans cell apart from CD1A?
CD207.
CD207. Also. C1A, CD207, and the answer is Langerhans cells. So Himant gets 10 points. Now coming to team. Nimisha, are you ready for your question?
Yes, sir. Yes, I'm ready, sir.
So here's your question.
Sir,
I can't see.
Not clear. And the screen is not.
Okay, now.
Yes, sir, it's clear, sir.
Identify the mark structure and name a genetic disorder associated with this structure. Mark structure is this one.
Yes, sir. This is a keratinocytes, and
the keratinocytes, they are mark structure.
Desmosomes
is the wrong answer. So disorder associated, it's definitely not desmosomes.
Not desmosomes, sir. Filaggrin.
No.
I'm not sure, sir.
Okay. So, this privileged members, Neurin and Stress, can you answer it? Can you try for it?
Sir, keratin intermediate filaments, hemidesmosome.
Excellent. So, and can you, it's a basal keratinocyte. So, what kind of keratins will you find it?
So keratin 5 and 14.
Excellent. So, if keratin 5 and 14 is mutated, what genetic disorder can you expect?
Sir, epiderma bullosa simplex.
Excellent. So the answer is keratin 5 and 14. See, this is a keratin 5 and 14. So, and which is also attached to the hemidesmosomes, and which in turn connect to the lamina docida, lamina densa, and sublamina densa. So the structure of dermoepidermal junction is very much essential. So they might ask this in your NEET. So which is the structure? So it is very important to know. So that was keratin 5 and 14. It was epidermolysis bullosa simplex caused due to keratin 5-4 mutation. Sorry, Nishmita, you will not get any marks for this question.
Yes, sir.
So at the end of round one, can we have the scores, please?
Yes, sir. At the end of round one, we have Ms. Ashmita Jain having 10 points, Mr. Srinath Rao having 10 points, Dr. Vallabh Sheth with 5 points, Dr. Himang Gupta having 10 points, and Dr. Nimisha yet to open the account.
Okay, that was a very, very impressive round one. It was a good start. So, and yeah, so let's go and move on to the next round. And those who haven't still started their account, this is a good opportunity for you to catch up. Okay, so we'll go start with round two now.
Ma'am, can you repeat the scoring pattern for this round?
Okay, I think.
Scorer, can you please repeat the scores?
Ms. Ashmita having 10 points, Mr. Srinath with 10 points, Dr. Vallabh with 5 points, Dr. Himang with 10 points, and Dr. Nimisha yet to open the account.
Okay, so can we start now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the instructions are the same. Images will be presented to each team. Observe them clearly and answer the associated questions. There will be no passing questions. So if you're unable to answer, it will go to our privileged participants. Each question fetches you 10 points. And again, answer should be clear. Multiple answers will not be counted. Team D. Tina?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, identify the instrument shown in image one, the first image on your left, and then identify the condition shown in the image.
It's a Wood's lamp.
Very good.
And the condition shown is erythrasma.
Very good. So can you tell me what is the wavelength of the Wood's lamp which you use?
311 to 13.
No. Any Shreyas or Nure?
360 nanometers.
365 nanometers. And what type of fluorescence will you see on erythrasma?
Coral
red fluorescence.
Coral red. Very good. So 10 points goes to Srinath. The Wood's lamp 365 nanometer, and as he said, you'll have coral red fluorescence. Okay, so the next question is, which is Vallabh.
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you hear me? Okay, we'll start. So a 26-year-old sexually active homosexual male presented with a solitary painless indurated ulcer. So you have to identify the condition and name the reaction associated with treatment of this condition.
So the syphilitic ulcer.
Okay, very good.
Herxheimer reaction. Jarisch-Herxheimer reaction.
Very good. So what made you go to the diagnosis of syphilis?
First is it's a painless ulcer.
Very good.
Solitary painless. It's and
indurated ulcer. So usually indurated. They have, it'll be like hard ulcer, which is that indurated ulcer, solitary, and so this is, he was absolutely right. So this is syphilis and this is Jarisch-Herxheimer reaction, which is a transient clinical reaction that occurs in patients which are infected with any kind of spirochetal infections, not only with syphilis. So that's one learning point that you need to remember, because you can see it even in other like spirochetal infections like Lyme disease or leptospirosis. So don't only associate it with syphilis. Okay, so this is Jarisch-Herxheimer reaction. Okay, so the team D. Himak, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, okay. Ma'am, I'm ready.
So the image shows clinical test. So you're supposed to identify this test and name the condition for which this test is used.
Ma'am, this is a patch test.
Very good.
It is used for allergic contact, like contact dermatitis.
Very good, very good. So this is a patch test. We usually do it on the back in cases of allergic contact dermatitis. Can you tell me which type of hypersensitivity reaction is allergic contact dermatitis?
It is type 4.
Yeah, very good. So this is very important because we have to differentiate it from irritant contact dermatitis. So irritant contact dermatitis develops immediately, but allergic contact dermatitis, it takes time because it's a type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. So again, 10 points to Himank. Okay. Sini, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am. I'm ready.
Okay. So here's your question. So there are two images which have been displayed.
Yes,
you have
ma'am.
Identified the condition and name the anti-malarial treatment used, anti-malarial used in the treatment of the above condition.
Ma'am, this is a malar rash that we see in SLE.
Very good.
And the anti-malarial that we use is the hydrochloroquine, quinine. That
very good. Okay, yeah, she identified it exactly correctly. That's the malar rash. So you can see that there is a sparing of the nasolabial folds. So that is malar rash and HCQs. And can just for learning purposes, can you tell me what are the antibodies that are associated with SLE?
Ma'am, the anti-Smith and the anti-DNA antibodies are what are you used to identify.
Okay, fine. Very good. So next, team A.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is your question. You can see three images that have been displayed. So you're supposed to identify the syndrome and identify the condition shown in image one.
Ma'am, this is Sturge-Weber syndrome.
Excellent.
And the condition in image one is a port wine stain, usually seen in trigeminal nerve distribution.
Very good. So that exactly as Ashmita said, this is like Sturge-Weber syndrome. This is the triad. Usually there is tram track calcifications which is seen, and then you have glaucoma and port wine stain. So very good. I think Ashmita also gets 10 points. Okay, so we'll go on to the next round.
Cora, can we have the scores, please?
Yeah. Yes, sir. At the end of round two, the total scores are as follows. Ms. Ashmita with 20 points, Mr. Srinath with 20 points, Dr. Vallabh with 15 points, Dr. Himank with 20 points, and Dr. Nimisha with 10 points.
Okay. So this round is round three, and round three is on drugs. There'll be no passing of questions, as told before, and again, each question has two sub-questions. Each sub-question carries 5 points each. So, question one. Now, this question starts with Team D. Team D, Himank, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
So, the first question is, FDA-approved topical drug for this condition, which is shown below. And the second sub-part is, this drug was initially introduced for which condition?
So this is androgenic alopecia, and minoxidil and finasteride, two drugs are used for this condition.
Okay. Can you be more specific? FDA approved topical drug.
It is minoxidil.
Okay. You get 5 points. So what was initially minoxidil used for?
So minoxidil is a potassium channel opener.
You're right. So initially it was used for?
For arrhythmias.
So the question, we can try. We have another 10 seconds left. Okay, the question passes to The privileged members.
Sir, hypertension. Yes.
Urine, stress, anyone?
Sir, initially used for hypertension.
Excellent, excellent. Minoxidil was initially used for hypertension, recalcitrant hypertension. So, Himang, you'll get 5 points. And the next question is for Team E. Nimisha.
Yes, sir.
So, what is the common drug used to treat the condition below?
Sir, these are vesicles which are found in herpes. And acyclovir is the common drug that we use.
Excellent. So, which is the drug used in the patient who develops drug resistance to above drug?
So it's called, I can't remember, falcalcitrant. It starts with an F, I think. It's
you're right, but we can't take that answer. So, we'll go to the privileged members, Nurin and Stress.
Flucytosin.
No, not flucytosin.
Foscarnet.
Excellent, excellent. So, acyclovir is the treatment of choice for herpes. And for primary lesions, we give 400 mg thrice daily for 7 to 10 days. And foscarnet is used for acyclovir resistant herpes, where you give intravenous 40 to 80 mg per kg every 8 hours until clinical resolution. So, Nimisha, you get 5 points for telling acyclovir. And now the question is for Team A. Ashmita, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
So, for Team A, the question is, name a monoclonal antibody acting against IgE. And the second subpart is, name the FDA-approved indication for which the above drug can be used.
So, omalizumab, and it can be used for bronchial asthma.
Excellent, excellent. So, Ashmita gets 10 points. The monoclonal antibody is omalizumab. It is anti-IgE monoclonal antibody. FDA has approved for 3 conditions, moderate to severe persistent asthma, chronic idiopathic urticaria, and nasal polyps. These are the FDA approved indications for omalizumab. Can anyone tell me the dosage of omalizumab, if anyone knows? And the route of administration?
The route is subcutaneous, I guess.
Excellent, excellent. Subcutaneous. The dosage?
Dose? No, sir. Dose, I don't know.
Dosage is 150 to 300 mg, given twice weekly or monthly, depending upon the clinical patient's condition. So the next question is for Team B. Srinath, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Team B. Name the drug of choice for dermatitis herpetiformis and mechanism of action of the same.
Dermatitis herpetiformis seen in celiac disease.
Okay, the antibodies are similar. Okay, and what is the drug of choice?
No idea, sir.
Okay.
Mechanism is against IgE antibodies.
No. So, anyways, you will not get any points for this, but I'll give you a clue for you, Srinath.
Yes,
the drug of choice which is used in leprosy also. That drug.
Clofazimine, sir?
No.
Dapsone.
The other drugs. There are only 3 drugs which are used like commonly.
Dapsone.
Yes. The drug of choice is Dapsone.
Okay,
so, and the mechanism of action of Dapsone, anyone?
Sir, dihydrofolate reductase inhibitor.
Okay, but
prevents the neutrophilic infiltration.
True, very true. In dermatitis herpetiformis, it's true. It prevents neutrophilic infiltration. But we were more concentrating about folic acid synthesis inhibitor, the drug of choice. So Dapsone inhibits, but this has nothing to do with dermatitis herpetiformis more, because in dermatitis herpetiformis, it prevents, Dapsone is used as a preventer of neutrophilic trafficking. So that is the main drug of action. So coming to the next question, Team C, Vallabh.
Yes.
So Vallabh, this is your next question. Identify the condition and name a drug which causes this condition.
The drug which can cause it is
in any condition, if you see, this is looking similar to something which you daily see on the roads. So you can take a wild guess. Near the temples and all, you can see, but you can take a wild guess from it. Identifying the condition, it's named.
Looks like someone has whipped himself.
You are almost right. So, okay, you can try for the second one. Name a drug which causes any random guess.
Causes mast cell release, so I'm guessing.
No. You were partially right in the first question. Privileged members, anyone can try?
So, bleomycin.
Excellent. The drug is bleomycin. The condition?
I'm not sure. I'm not remembering the name.
It was partially right. It looks like someone has been whipped. Someone has whipped him. It is known, also known as whiplash dermatitis.
Flagellate dermatitis.
The condition is flagellate dermatitis. It is characterized by parallel linear or curvilinear arrangements simulating the marks of whiplashes. It was initially termed for bleomycin-induced dermatitis. So these are the conditions which can cause those flagellate kind of dermatitis. So the true flagellation is in religious punishment, torture, and drugs like bleomycin, doxycycline. These are the drugs which can cause flagellate dermatitis. And shiitake mushroom ingestion can also cause flagellate dermatitis. So can we have this course?
Yes, sir. At the end of round 3, Ms. Okay. Ashmita is having 30 points. Mr. Srinath is with 20 points. Dr. Vallabh has 15 points. Dr. Himank has 25 points. And Dr. Nimisha has 15 points.
Okay. The scores are very tight, and rapid fire is the round when you can make a difference. So rapid fire. So Hira will take over with the rapid fire.
I feel all the participants are answering very well. It's very impressive. So I think this is the round which you can catch up or you can take the lead. Okay, so this will start with we'll start with the first team. Okay, Team D. Are you ready? Himank? Can you hear us?
Yes, ma'am, I'm ready. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you're ready? We'll start.
Yes, ma'am.
So remember, there are 10 questions. Think, answer, but don't waste too much time on each question. Okay, so you get 1 minute. Okay,
ma'am.
Okay, all the best.
1 minute on each question?
No, 1 minute for
or
all.
Just overall.
Okay, so so you have to answer very quickly, okay?
Ma'am, each question carries...
Easy questions, okay?
Ma'am, each question carries 1 mark, right?
3 marks.
3 marks.
3 marks, okay. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so all the very best. Do it. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So we'll start by first question. Transient layer of epidermis found in palms and sole.
Stratum lucidum.
Very good. Moth eaten, alopecia seen in.
Syphilis.
Okay. Organism causing oral hairy leukoplakia.
It's a virus, I think Epstein-Barr virus.
Very good. Hanging curtain sign seen in?
Pteriasis. Pteriasis, I think it's a versicular. No, second one. Rosacea.
Okay, we'll go to the next one. Okay, next question. School of fish appearance seen in?
Haemophilus ducreyi. Heart shank.
Okay, mechanism of action of cyclosporin?
Calcium urine inhibitor.
Okay, diaplated brick wall appearance seen in?
Heli disease.
Okay. Wrist drop is caused due to injury to which nerve?
Radial nerve.
Okay. Narco color kit for pelvic inflammatory disease?
Yellow.
Okay. What is cross sign?
No idea.
Okay. Okay, so we're done. Almost finished. Okay, so let's. Okay, so 24 points. Okay, these are the answers to the questions. Else tell what is cross sign? Anyone?
Axillary.
Very good. Seen it?
Neurofibromatosis.
Very good. Okay. So these are the answers. He was right. Transient layer of epidermis found in palms and soles was stratum lucidum. Moth eaten. Alopecia is actually, he said syphilis, but yeah, we'll take that correct. It's secondary syphilis. EBV is causes oral hairy leukoplakia. Hanging curtain sign is P. rosea. Okay. Pityriasis rosea. And school of fish appearance, he said it right. Haemophilus ducreyi, mechanism of action of cyclosporin, calcium urine inhibitor, diaphyllated brick wall appearance, Hailey-Hailey disease, wrist drop is occurs due to injury to radial nerve, and narco color kit for PID is yellow. And cross sign, you answered it. So you get 24 points, Hemang. Good job. And okay, so the next one is Nimisha.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so answer clearly. Take your time, but you'll have only 1 minute.
Okay? Yes, ma'am.
So we're ready for the time. I'm going to start. Good luck. Prickle layer of epidermis is?
Stratum spinosum.
Okay, swarm of bees appearance seen in?
Ma'am, okay, next. So
one. Okay. Vector for Chagas disease?
And Trypanosoma cruzi. Trypanosoma. ZZ.
Okay, we'll go to the next one. Circle of Hebra seen in?
Ma'am, circle of Hebra is seen in scabies.
Okay. Buschke Ollendorff sign seen in?
Ma'am, I don't know.
Okay, mechanism of action of ivermectin?
Ma'am, it causes paralysis of the parasite.
Okay, but
spastic.
What channel? Spastic. Anything? Okay, we'll go to the next one. Okay. Sawtooth appearance?
Ma'am, I don't.
Intradermal skin test for leprosy?
Lepromin.
Okay, I'm sorry, but your time is up.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can others try? You got 3 right answers, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, in others can try, what is prickle layer of epidermis?
Stratum spinosum.
Spinosum.
Okay, very good. Swarm of bees appearance seen in?
Alopecia areata.
Excellent. Vector for Chagas disease?
Ludovic-Bug.
Good. Circle of Hebra, she answered. Buschke Ollendorff sign seen in?
Secondary syphilis.
Oh, very good. Mechanism of action of ivermectin?
Opens chloride channels, causes spastic paralysis.
Okay, very good. Sawtooth appearance seen in?
Lichen planus.
Very good. Intradermal skin test for leprosy?
Lepromin test.
Wow, very good. Drugs in kit 5?
Kit 5, cotrimoxazole, doxycycline.
What is kit 5?
Okay, yellow, ma'am. Red. It's red, ma'am.
Okay, yeah.
Acyclovir.
Very good. Vogue's diet, what are the components?
Ma'am, poikilotherma.
Epilepsy, loss of intelligence, and adenoma sedation.
Oh, that's very good. You answered everything. So, yeah, the next. Okay. So, Nimisha gets 9 points. We'll go on to the next person, which is Team E. Okay, team A, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Ashmita, okay, are you ready? Any doubts?
Yes, ma'am.
I can start?
No, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so don't waste too much time. If you don't, go ahead.
Ma'am, can I just read the questions and answer instead of you reading out the questions?
Okay, yeah. Okay, pass. Okay. Yes, I'll start. Okay, for the sake of the audience, I'll keep saying it, but you can read it out loud. You can tell the answers fast, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Cells that contain Burbeck granule?
Langerhans cells. Nikolsky sinus staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome or any acantholytic conditions. Rose Gardner's disease, porotrix shankai. Pickett fins appearance is seen in this one. IJV thrombosis. IJV thrombosis, groove sign is LGV, lymphogranuloma venereum. Mechanism of action of rifampicin is RNA polymerase inhibitor. Buddha ear appearance, I don't know. Satellite lesions are seen in borderline tuberculoid leprosy. Drugs in blue kit. Drugs in blue kit are azithral and benzathine penicillin, and Hanifin Rajka sign is atopic dermatitis.
Okay, so very good. But yeah, there are a few things which I thought Nikolsky sign, but I'll give it to you. You were saying cephalococcal scarlet skin syndrome. That is actually pseudo Nikolsky. Okay, because there's something called Nikolsky sign is because when the separation of the cells, when they separate because of pressure when you apply. Pseudo-Nikolsky is because of this necrosis, but since you said Nikolsky sign, we're going to give it right. And then picket fence appearance, anyone else can try that? It's on DIF.
Actually, what Ashmita said, picket fence, that was fever.
Yeah.
Which is seen in the thrombosis. Yeah.
This is the appearance on DIF.
Yes. Picket fence, yeah.
Even the audience can unmute yourself and answer, okay?
Yeah. Anyone? Audience can answer. You don't have to raise your hand.
Kaustubh.
Pemphigus vulgaris.
Picket fence. No, actually not pemphigus vulgaris.
Ma'am, epidermal bullosa acquisita.
So I'll give you a clue. Okay, so what happens is the deposits are seen only on the tips. Okay, so because of that, it looks on DIF, it looks like there is, it's picket fence appearance. So I'll give you a clue. It's like IgA deposits will be seen on
dermatitis
the...
Dermatitis.
Very good. Okay, so that's picket fence appearance. Then group sign, she answered. Mechanism of rifampicin, she answered. Buddha, your appearance?
Is it keloid?
Oh, no. It's like this appearance is because of the elongation and infiltration of the ear lobe. Where do you think you will see that condition? Anyone can answer, audience, privileged participant. Okay, so you basically in lepromatous leprosy, you get to see it. And then, actually, blue kit is for what?
Syphilis.
Syphilis. So you'll have benzathine, penicillin, and doxycycline in it. And then Hanifin Rajka criteria for atopic dermatitis. Okay, so Ashmita got 7 questions right. Okay, so 21 points to Ashmita. Okay, so you guys are doing very well. And I'd like to hand over the last. Okay, so and then we'll continue for the next team.
Yes, ma'am.
Team B, that is Srinath. Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Any questions, any doubts? Can I carry on?
Yes.
Okay, good luck. Layer of epidermis, also known as stratum germinatum.
Stratum BC.
Very good. Dewdrop appearance.
Chickenpox. Chickenpox. And
okay,
causative organism of staphylococcus.
Okay, strawberry cervix
is seen in Trichomonas vaginalis.
Okay, Wimberger sign seen in?
Wimberger sign, next question.
Okay, methotrexate. Mechanism of action, methotrexate?
The folic acid, dihydrofolic acid inhibitor.
Okay, good. Septate tomato appearance seen in? On histopathology?
Don't know my next question.
Okay, animal model used in leprosy?
Animal model, armadillo, ma'am.
Good. Narcokit color for urethral discharge?
Urethral discharge, green color. Gray color.
allergen causing bindi dermatitis.
Toluidine, paraamino.
Okay. So you're done with your questions. You got most of your things right, but few things. Can someone tell me where do you see septate tomato appearance?
Sorry, erythema nodal. Sorry.
No, any other try? This is actually a very important, neat question because they will show you the histopathological figure.
Ma'am, molluscum contagiosum.
Very good. So molluscum contagiosum is where you see septate tomato appearance. And then NACO kit for urethral discharge, I think you said the correct answer, but it was your second thing. So I think we can't give you that point. Okay. And okay, so an allergen, I think everything else you got, right? Layer of epidermis, also known as stratum germinatum, is basal. Dewdrop appearance is seen in varicella. A botryomycosis, causative organism, staph aureus. Strawberry cervix is in Trichomonas vaginalis. Wimberger sign is seen in syphilis. Can someone tell me what is the Wimberger sign? Anybody?
Ma'am, the tibia is affected. Wimberger.
Very good. Yeah. Okay, then he said it right. A dihydrofolate reductase inhibitor, septate tomato. Animal model used in leprosy is armadillo. Any other animal model used?
Foot pad of mice.
Mouse pad foot.
Very good. And NACO kit. An allergen causing bindi dermatitis. This is another point which is repeatedly asked in NEET questions also. So this you need to know. Para tertiary butyl phenol. Okay, so going to the next. Vala, are you ready?
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
And I would like to say... Srinath got 6 correct. Okay, so we get 18 points. Okay, next, Vala. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Any doubts?
No doubts.
Okay, so we'll start. Okay, you have 1 minute and your time starts now. Stratum spinosum and stratum basal together is also known as?
Stratum germinatum.
Apple jelly nodules on dioscopy seen in?
Tuberculosis, scrofuloderma.
Million year sign used to differentiate which two conditions?
Next question.
If you don't know, Goha. Pup 10 sign seen in?
Next question.
Clue cells are seen in?
Bacterial vaginosis. Mechanism of action
mechanism
of is 50S ribosomal inhibitor.
Claw clutching bone.
Next question.
Generation time of Mycobacterium leprae.
2 months.
NACO kit used for inguinal bugle.
Black. Heliotrope okay. Rash is seen in dermatomyositis.
Okay. Okay. So he answered well, but there were a few questions which are missed out. The first question, he got 3 answers which were right. Okay, you can answer like that if, like, you can switch on your, you can unmute yourself and answer. Stratum spinosum and stratum basal together are known as?
Multigen layer.
Okay, apple jelly nodules, where else you see it?
Apple vulgaris.
Lupus vulgaris.
Lupus vulgaris.
Lupus vulgaris. Good. Milan, your sign?
Erysipelas and cellulitis.
Very good. So, what is this sign? Can you just elaborate?
Ma'am, in erysipelas, there will be involvement of the ear, ma'am. But in cellulitis, in soft tissues, cannot be involved. It won't be involved.
The subcutaneous tissue is not there in the ear. So, cellulitis involves the deeper tissues. So, that's why it doesn't affect the ear. So, that is Milan's ear sign. Puptide sign?
Lichen planus.
Okay, very good. Mechanism of action of doxycycline. He got it almost, but then...
Ribosome.
Sorry?
30S ribosomal unit in the
30S. Clock clutching ball appearance seen in?
Lichenitis.
Okay. Generation time of leprosy?
12 days.
Good. Very good. NACO kit used for inguinal bugle?
Black.
Yeah, that he said, right? And heliotropic rash is seen in dermatomyositis. Okay. So can we have this course now, please?
Yes, ma'am. At the end of all the rounds, the final scores are as follows.
Don't announce final scores now. Well, this round scores you announce, Pallavi.
Okay. Fourth round, rapid fire round scores are as follows. Miss Ashmita has got 21 points. Mr. Srinath has got 18 points. Dr. Vallabh has got 9 points. Dr. Hima Gupta has got 24 points. And Dr. Nimisha has got 9 points.
And for Hima, Dr. Hira, I have one doubt. Can this Miss Ashmita and our Shreyas, can they write upcoming the PG dermatology exam is there, no? Final year exam.
Definitely.
I don't know who is the winner or whatever the scores, I don't know. But today, Quizmaster had a very minimum job to do. Only one answer they could answer is Buddha year. As I remember, only Buddha year, they had to answer rest. Everything, 99.9% of the questions were answered by our participants. You don't know Sachin and Hira, you don't know how happy I am today. My sole purpose or intention of serve, like starting this white term is done today. The way they answered, their knowledge. The best part about today's quiz was Hira and Sachin, you made sure, not unlike all other quizzes, you didn't ask some factual questions. What is that? You in each question, including the science maybe. See, you went to next step asking what is a Wimberger sign. They told what is that. You made sure that the concept is clear there. What is that? Everything in detail they know. And it's like this quiz was more like it was a detailed dermatology class itself. It was not like a quiz. Okay. Through each question, you made sure one concept is learned. Through each question, it's definitely that concept is cleared. So through each question, we learned a lot. Most of the important aspects of the dermatology is we learned today. I hope the same feeling or experience with all our participants today. I want to know the feedback from all our participants before announcing the results. We shall start with Nurin.
Yes, sir.
Nurin, you answered very well. So I wanted you to be the finalist. You just missed. I feel bad for you. Anyway, how was the experience?
I enjoyed it a lot, sir. All questions were very good.
No. Initially, in the beginning, you seemed a bit nervous. How you are feeling now? How is your your preparation level? How confident you are for your upcoming entrance exam?
I feel more confident, sir, after all this.
Yeah, good. So what about standards? Yeah, these are all here already mentioned. These are all the standard questions for any PG entrance exam. So if you know this much, and more than this, all of you know the things very well. But the only thing what's lacking is self-confidence. You all don't have self-confidence. These quizzes, all these weekly quizzes, all these we conduct just to boost your confidence levels. That's all. You people are very good in your knowledge, but the factor missing there is the confidence thing. Okay. So please boost your confidence levels. Then definitely you will be succeed in any kind of examinations. What about other participants? Shreyas, how was this? Shreyas, how was the...
It was very good.
You are terrible, man. You are terrible. Okay. Good that you are not in the main slot, because others would have not got any chance to answer in front of you. You are really amazing. Okay. How was the questions?
It was very good, sir. Very standard questions. Well, this was my first white army quiz, sir.
Yeah.
So very nice experience, sir.
Yeah. Thing is that, through what I again want to stress is, through each question, they made sure you learnt one thing in detail. Am I right?
Huh? Yes, sir. It was very detailed. It was more like learning than rather than competition.
Exactly. What about Ashmita?
Yes, sir. I thoroughly enjoyed the quiz. Initially, I was like, to be very honest, when I saw the notification of this dermatology quiz on the WhatsApp group, I was like, dermat is a final year subject. But then I thought, let's give it a try. I have sufficient time. Like, if I start from the scratch and if I try to, maybe I can. And so I'm feeling very good that I've done I've reached this level in dermat quiz, like being it a final year subject, and I've just come into third year. I'm just done with my second year exams. Always, white army quizzes are always amazing.
All over, especially all over those who achieved. Okay, we have so many in our White Army Corps members also, like Vijay Balaji, Astray, we have Ryan McLean, many of them. achieved so much in their academics, or maybe just because of now we have Akshay Rao also. They all have achieved so much just by participating in quizzes. See, take today's example, Ashmita. She came to know about the quiz and lasts for 1 week. Within 1 week, she completed the entire dermatology book. So that's also like target also for the quiz I have to prepare. So keeping this in mind, she completed the entire subject within 1 week. So that subject also you could read within a week span, and you could complete that. You could learn many more concepts. And by that, at the end for revision, you have a quiz like this, wherein you can learn, like revise thoroughly all the aspects of that subject. And at the end, you end up boosting up your confidence levels also. So this is the advantage of participating in quizzes. And Ashmita, I should admit, you did brilliantly. You did brilliantly. You are like nothing less than any third year postgraduate in dermatology. Okay. Well done. Sir. What about Srinath? Srinath and Himank.
Yes, sir.
Nimishya.
Yes, sir. It was my first quiz.
Srinath, yeah.
Yes, sir. It was my first quiz in White Army, sir. It was really good, sir. And also now I know like what things I should focus once the things open up and I go to postings in dermatology.
Is that, no, nothing that you know everything. What I felt is you need one more revision. You know, yes, you knew the answers, most of the answers, but that you were a bit like bit confused. So if you revise once more, now you'll be very good. You are the best I felt among all. Just think the one thing was lacking was one more revision you required. Okay, do that and you will be the best. Okay, yes, Srinath, I really appreciate your answering today and efforts. Very well done. What about Vallabh?
Yes, sir. So like Shreya said, it was a great learning experience. It was a great revision for me also.
Yeah, you are busy, occupied in the internship now. Whatever you read in final year, you're a little forgotten. Okay, only thing is that you're very much occupied in your work now. But make sure that whatever you read in final year, you are very good. I have seen myself. Okay, but now that you I can understand. But don't leave studying. Okay, meanwhile, while working also, just keep revising whatever notes you have, or yes, keep watching your videos, or keep solving MCQs as many as possible. Okay, this will keep you updated and better and better, make you better and better. Very well done, Vallabh. I can understand your condition very well. So you are never less than anyone here. You are very good. And keep up your confidence levels, okay?
Thank you.
Well done. And what about Nimishya?
Sir, to be very honest, I just came back from duty and I gave the quiz just like that. So when you called, I was taken quiet at a surprise and I was very, very nervous. But after giving the quiz, I am so impressed by all the other candidates and especially Ashmita. And I know that I have to work very, very hard for this dermatology, but it was a great, great learning experience. It was the first quiz that I ever, I think, qualified.
And that is our sole purpose too, to make all of us learn more and better about a subject from the experts. Okay, that our intention is met today from that's because that is possible only because of the participants' efforts. See, anything can be made successful, but it's mutual. They see quiz masters have prepared such good questions, such standard questions. But if the participants are not prepared well, and if they're not answering well, then the purpose is not met. But today is what it was. Too good. Sachin, what's your experience, Sachin and Hira?
Kishan, I would like to say to all the participants, framework, how we prepared the questions.
Okay.
So it was like we know our professors they get instructions from the NEET board. They have to set few questions and send it to the NEET board.
Okay.
So they are instructed in such a way that the candidate should not be able to answer if they are not attended internship.
Okay.
So the questions which they send from our college, like Bangalore Medical College, or where we are doing SRship now, the professors are planning such questions. The candidates will not be answered if they don't attend the clinics.
Exactly.
So our questions are like that. So
all clinically oriented.
The slits and smear. So if you attend the internship program, you will definitely able to know. I think Vallabh is facing difficulty because it was COVID times, and as you know, BMC is entirely shut. Okay. Only for and COVID patients have been taking in. So the questions will be henceforth in. You will be able to answer if you attend the clinics well.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'd like to say attend clinics, especially for short subjects like dermat, which will be a game changer. everyone will do well in medicine questions, surgery questions, anatomy, physiology. The main game changers are the short subjects. That's what differentiates from being the top rankers from 100, 200 ranks. So what I did, and standard of questions, Kishan, last time when we met, the candidates were not able to answer around, they were, the percentage of answering was around 60%. Now it is more than 95%. So next time, I think we should do PG level quizzes for the UGC.
Sachin, what I felt about dermatology is, it's not a subject which we can learn by just studying or reading the books. It's a subject which we can learn only by seeing the patients or seeing in the wards, by attending the postings. Only then we can differentiate the conditions and clinically diagnose the conditions. Not otherwise. Just by reading the mere books, we can maybe very minimum we can learn. So knowledge should be there, but more of the better part of the dermatology can be learned only by attending the postings and just like you said, attending the internship properly and seeing the as many patients as possible. Hira, we want some concluding remarks from you, please.
No, I would just like to say this was...
You were too good today, Hira. You were too good today. You motivated our participants very nicely. You are too good.
Thank you, Dr. Kishan. No, because I really had a lot of fun actually preparing these questions because as Sachin said, our staff do get instructions and now the problem which was being faced is mainly interns are not attending postings and they're just sitting and studying. So now if that's how the questions are going to be, you want to know a little interesting and it should be like a learning aspect. Like each question you should go back, like so if that basement membrane zone, it was just not like only that one disease, you should go back and read and see, okay, the whole basement membrane. All these are just important topics and I think everyone did very well, like they surpassed our expectations and I think all of them, like see, even like some like Nimisha, she said she was not like prepared, but yeah, she still answered, like she gave it her best and I'm very impressed with everyone. So it was a good experience.
And the questions were slightly twisted. What I felt is they seemed very simple, but slightly twisted. Okay, but there you made it very interesting. The questions were really interesting, and this was compared to last time. This was very standard questions this time, and very interesting also. And the participants also really did well. So finally, can we have the scores from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, please, Miss Pallavi?
Yes, sir. The final scores are as follows. At fourth place, we have a tie with 24 points, Dr. Vallabh Sheth and Dr. Nimisha Jun.
Very good.
At third place, we have Mr. Srinath Rao with 38 points. At second place, we have Dr. Hima Gupta with 49 points.
Okay.
And at the first place, we have Ms. Ashmita Jain with 51 points.
Great. Congratulations, all of you. We don't mind about the scores because your knowledge or this thing doesn't depend on one day's performance or on this or just on this quiz. But what we are happy is all of you done very good, equally good. Most of them are most of the questions were answered today. So we are really happy about all our participants, in the preliminary rounds also. Scores just mere numbers. Okay, don't take it very seriously. Just be happy and be confident. Yeah, you participate in such a PG level quiz and you all did really well. That's all our take home thing today. Okay, so Ashmita, and you should be really happy today, most happiest. Okay, and
Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah, and she recently she's a core member of White Army as well since 2 days. Okay, she's doing really well, she's very active member. So keep participating. I request all our members to keep participating in all the discussions and all the quizzes. This is a way to revise things and mainly to see these are all what we do. Why we do is just to increase our boost up our confidence levels. Okay. So keep doing that. And Sachin, my brother, thank you very much. And thank you very much with your own interest. You both of you conducted this quiz. And when we requested, I was pampering you a lot for conducting dermatology classes, but you made sure that through one quiz, you made sure that all the classes were covered in this one quiz. Okay, all the important, really, really. I'm not exaggerating things. all the important aspects of the dermatology, all the classes. If you had conducted 10 classes also, we could not have learned so much, which you made sure through one quiz, okay? And it was, you made it very interesting. That's the best aspect, okay? And also, yeah, as I already mentioned, you just like other quiz masters, you just mentioned the like signs or the whatever it is. You also made sure that what is that sign, and everyone will know in detail about that question, okay? So, and in and around that question also, the in and around that question also are discussed. So nicely done, so nicely. And we would like to expect, we are expecting much more from you both in coming days. Okay, please. And the open secret is that for all of us, including our own White Army's motto is help others to help ourselves. The open secret is the more we teach others, the better we learn. Indirectly, we are the one who learning here by conducting these quizzes and it's whatever the discussions in White Army also. I mean, still in touch with all the 18 subjects just because of doing all this. So I am the most benefited person here. Okay. So anyway, thank you so much, Dr. Hira and Dr. Sachin. Special thanks and goes to you both.
Don't think that can we have the tiebreakers questions if just for we have 3-4 questions anybody can answer.
Yeah, sure.
So these were the tiebreaker questions which we had made. So anyone can answer. Not it's not directed to anyone. It's just this thing. Can you identify the sign from the image? Anyone from the audience also can try. It is a plaque which is present over the concha of the ear. Anyone? Okay. This is just a sign which is seen in discoid lupus erythematosus. In discoid lupus erythematosus, the concha will be involved. There is scaling which is present in concha. So it's a shastra sign. So complete the triad. This is a condition associated with HLA-B15.
The Behçet's disease, uveitis, should be the third component.
Excellent. The third component will be uveitis. This is a repeat question, which was already mentioned in some the paper, I guess. What is the diagnosis?
Hailey-Hailey disease.
What is the appearance known as?
Dilapidated brick wall appearance.
Excellent. So this was one more rapid fire tiebreaker question.
Drug A is
drug B.
Drug A is terbinafine.
Excellent.
Drug B is azole group of drugs.
Excellent. Drug A is terbinafine and drug B is that was the end of the rapid fire.
Sachin, are you using laptop now?
Yes, Kishan.
Can we have a group photo, please, with all our finalists? Can you please take a screenshot? I'm using mobile. I can't. Can you please share with me later? All the participants, please smile, please. Finalists and all other participants who are there, please switch on and please smile for a group photo.
This one will be nice.
Pallavi and our host moderators also, please join. Sachin, with the first slide, maybe the first slide.
Okay.
This will remain as a memory for us. After a few years, we can say yes, we had a. Is like this, and we had so many good participants. Now they're doing really well, and many derma. See, we don't know because of this quiz only. Ashmita end up doing dermatology and becoming the best dermatologist in India. We don't know. So when she becomes that, we should have some proof, na? We also should take some credits, no? That's why we want this proof. It's done.
Yeah, it's done, Kishan.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much for this lovely and wonderful quiz, and also for all the participants, and also motivating and supporting members of the White Army. We thank each and everyone on behalf of all the members of White Army. Thank you so much, especially Sachin and Dr. Hira. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Kishan. And these certificates will be sent to you, mailed to you at the earliest, please send your participants' details to us. Okay, the certificates will be sent to you as at the earliest. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.